I was to ask you to picture the most fanatical Western Sydney Wanderers fan, who would you think of? Would it be one of the guys in the RBB swinging his scarf around? Would it be a little child with his family singing all the songs? Whatever you picture, I'm pretty sure it wouldn't be a former Miss Universe Australia winner, but that's exactly who it is. Laura Dundovic is not only the ambassador of the club, she's one of the biggest fans. So where did this whole Wanderers obsession come from?
I've sort of grown up in a soccer family. So I used to support Sydney United back in the day. And then after that, my brother played in the youth league for Northern Spirits. So we sort of went to all those games. And then I kind of like would go to some Sydney FC games, but I didn't really feel as connected to a club as I had back then. And then all of a sudden we sort of just over the last year and a bit, my brother kept talking about how the Wanderers were coming and they were going to be really good and it was going to be like the old days. And then we actually ran into Ante Milicic in Croatia and he was talking it up. And so, yeah, I've been to pretty much every game now.
So what do they do that makes you feel connected that maybe a Sydney FC doesn't do or another club?
I think it's definitely the culture. The players are just so passionate. They're fantastic to their fans, and then in the same way the fans are just so supportive. I mean, I hosted something with the Wanderers a few months back and the shopping centre was just layers and layers and layers. All the floors were just covered in fans cheering the whole time. I mean, they go all game. You know, I know a lot of them lose their voice over the game and they're dedicated, and I think it's just great to be a part of that.
Are you one of the ones that are there singing with the fans as well?
Hell yeah. Yeah, I know most of the chants. I do get right into it in the game.
What about your role as an ambassador? What does that entail? What do you have to do?
Look, I go to the games, support them, host some things with them. So it's good because I've got to know a few of the players, and a lot of people are jealous about that. You know, Shinji Ono, and yeah, it's pretty cool.
What about your days supporting Sydney United? You said earlier, what was
yeah,
that like?
I loved the Sydney United days. We used to go to all the games. I remember, because you guys used to train at King, so you'd play the game, and then when you were warming up at King Tom, there was that little field up the top.
Yeah.
And my brother used to sit up the top there and wait for everyone to come around and chase you with our autograph books. And I remember my brother got to be a ball boy and I didn't. I was pretty jealous, but I stood on the sideline and watched. And we loved it. I think also with Sydney United, because there was that Croatian connection, you know, if I went to a Croatian wedding, there'd be a player there or something, and we'd chase them around all night. And I remember one night, my brother and I, Kalutz was there, and we just kept going, "Spider, can you get the balloons for us?" Because he was tall. And like, you know, once might be cute, but we spent the whole night asking him to collect balloons for us. A bit lame.
What about your friends in the media, maybe people that aren't really associated with football? Do you try and get them to come to the Wanderers game?
Yeah. I take quite a few friends to games and that sort of thing. They love it. When I went to a few Sydney FC games over the last year before, I sort of would take a few friends to them. And they enjoy it. I think it's good. And I know now a lot of people know about this grand final on the weekend, which is fantastic. And I think it's a big difference to last year and the year before that.
Do you have any favourite players or favourite song for the Wanderers?
Favourite player? I love Poliak. I think he's a really sort of hard-working player, and I think he's probably my favourite. And my favourite chant, I suppose I probably, the other week the RBB split into two when they did the Championa, and that I thought was amazing, just watching it from the other side. But I've asked my brother if I can ever join the RBB, and he told me no, because both of my brothers are in there, and they told me no.
So you're not the cool sister, you're just like, get away from me.
No, he said I'm allowed at the games, but not in the RBB, so I've got to keep away.
And what about the grand final? Are you going to be there?
Yeah, I'm going to be there. I'm really excited, so I'm going with my mum and dad. My brothers are in the RBB, so yeah, it should be really good.
Do you play yourself?
I did play. I used to play outdoor, and I started when I was about 12, and it was quite hard then because there was no, you know, not a lot of girls were playing, so I had to play in the under 16s. So I kind of got a bit bullied for that because I was like, believe it or not, the small one. But I really loved indoor. I played a lot of that. And now whenever there's a chance, it's good because a lot of the time with what I do for work, there'll be like a charity day, or they might ask us to play soccer. I mean, a few months ago for the launch of the summer soccer for Football Australia, I got to play again. And I love it.
What position?
I used to be a defensive mid, but it kind of, it changes up now. It depends. When you're a girl, I think when they get there, and especially when it's mixed, they think, where are we going to put her where she doesn't have to do too much work?